Yeah, I need one, yes.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all so much for coming here today to cover the topic of customer centricity and how rebranding a mortgage firm ties to the operational need within the firm. My name is Sarah Hinkle-Morrison, and I'm an MBA student at the University of North Texas with a focus in marketing. And in collaboration with a team of students at UNT, including Emmanuel Iguana, Barsha Serene, Victor Chen, and Zhen Chen, I'm excited to present to you our following presentation for today. Now, before I begin, I would like each of you to introduce yourself very briefly. Tell me what brought you here today and what you hope to get out of this presentation. Would you like to start?
Okay, Kiwi Hughes, came to support you. I don't really know what I'm gonna get out of this. Hopefully something educational.
Okay.
Rachel Bittner, here for you.
Thank you. Heather Cherry, I'm here to support you and learn about marketing, please.
Thank you.
Zane Cundiff, I'm here to help you record and support you in your presentation.
Mm-hmm. Hannah, I'm here to support you, of course, and I'm hoping to learn something new.
Thank you.
Sandy, I'm here to support you as your parent and a professional woman in the work world.
And you?
Michael, I'm owner-operator of Two Surf Solutions, here to support you and learn more about the online mortgage business.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate you all coming here today and taking the time out of your day to be here. Let's go ahead and get started by reviewing the case study that all of you have attached to your packets. It should be towards the back, the next to last page. What I'd like each of you to do is to read over this case study, take about 5 minutes to review the questions, and think about some of your responses and how you would go about addressing this case study. I will set a timer on my phone, and when 5 minutes are about up, I will quickly go through those and discuss some of the ideas that you guys have.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, the first question I asked you was, what areas have been weak in the rebranding efforts of Mr. Cooper? What thoughts do you guys have on that? Yeah, Jay?
So I know they're rebranding, so what was their initial... They wanted people to get more self-service in there, so... Is there more specific stuff on how they made their rebranding effort? Was it more ad-based, or was it with their current clientele?
The one thing I want you to understand is the information that I provided you about the case study is all the information about the rebranding effort. Okay. In other words, they changed the name, but they didn't do much else.
Okay.
So do you think that's a weakness in their approach?
Yes.
One thing that strikes me is the name Mr. Cooper wasn't given any value. What does it mean to me as a client? What is a Mr. Cooper? Is that a name that people trust?
That's a very good point. Where did it come from?
Is it a long lost uncle? I don't know.
Any other thoughts on that?
On the Mr. Cooper, or just generally?
Just on the question in general.
I mean, their customer base, there's not any diversification across multi-generations.
So very weak diversity of customer base?
Multi-generational, and just the diversity there. They're all predominantly in an older age bracket, and predominantly just refinancing, not initial financing.
Mm-hmm. Good observation. Anybody have any other comments they want to add on there? You look like you have something, Rachel.
Well, a business, any business, I think, that isn't brick and mortar has some, like, I don't know. There's a problem with wanting to have a relationship with a place that doesn't have a place. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So being able to have that tangibility.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think the biggest issue is, like, I know what they stand for when I read Nation Star Mortgage Holdings, because that gives me some semblance of what I'm getting into. But if I read Mr. Cooper, I don't know if that's like an online username or if they're just like a self-help center for you to call for like a hotline. I don't know. Nobody knows what it is when they say Mr. Cooper. So.
Very good point. Moving on to the second question, what opportunity do you think there are available to Mr. Cooper as they continue the rebranding process?
Change the name.
Marketing, marketing, marketing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because there's no brand awareness. So you got to spend a ton of money to create brand awareness. If you don't have brick and mortar. Back to her point. So 26 million, you cut it.
I mean, yeah. I mean, it doesn't have to be about the name, though, too. If you look at Rocket Mortgage, they're online, they've branded the program. People know Quicken, QuickBooks, but Rocket Mortgage, right, homes you in and draws you in.
But mine.
To the program.
Mm-hmm. Any other thoughts on how they can create opportunities as they go forward rebranding themselves? Yeah?
The ease of access, or like the self-service click barrier, I guess. Like, something recently I've seen on social media is they're starting to put ads in everything. So if you see a video, you have an ad just like the internet or TV now. So I don't know if like Mr. Cooper can put money into that, because social media is a multi-generational thing as far as I'm aware. Because you can have a lot of, I don't know the specifics and the stats of age, but I've seen a lot of older people involved in social media that might be able to get awareness of that as well.
We'll actually touch on that a little bit later.
Yeah.
Any other ideas on how they can create opportunities in the rebranding? Yeah,
like a mascot or like a spokesperson?
Kind of to personify Mr. Cooper?
Yeah.
Like, why don't they have like a...
Just like the farmer's guy.
Like Dos Equis Mr. Cooper. The most interesting mortgage man in the
world,
right, or something. Like.
They're, but you know, like you're saying, Dos Equis, the farmer's guy.
Mm-hmm. Or the Verizon guy that switched to Sprint. Everybody knows why.
Exactly. Yeah. That's a great example. Any other thoughts on this question? I think you brought up a great point. Now the last question is, how can we take these opportunities and execute or implement them into Mr. Cooper's operations today?
Chair.
Let me ask a question. This is an operational question. We've been talking about marketing.
Yes, it is. So what is your question?
Well, there are two different issues. One is item one and two are marketing things. The third question is, how do I put this into operations versus Mr. Cooper's marketing?
Exactly, you raise a really good point, and we're actually going to touch on that.
Okay.
Any other thoughts on how you can put this into action in an operation?
Oh, uniforms or something. Every brand employee, the best way to promote yourself sometimes is to promote with your own employees, so they'll help sell for you. So make sure your employees are branded somehow with Mr. Cooper.
But my question to you is, since they're not brick and mortar, how would that presence be known among just general population?
I mean, you could take what Zane was saying earlier about the click access, ease of access you have on your board. That really can be transferred to that place.
So uniformity?
Click-throughs.
Okay. So if, you know, unlike what you were saying, some people don't want brick and mortar.
Mm-hmm.
Like, don't want to go to a boutique, don't want to go in a store. they want to go on, put their data, know it's privatized, and get a pre-qualification and finalize as much as they can away from a person. Not everyone, but...
Yeah.
So just to clarify, you said click-through?
Yeah, click-through.
Okay.
Reduction. The crowd, like she's talking about mostly refinance folks, so you just want to be able to like target your ads to like what are the like Hallmark Channel or something. You know, if you get the older crowd, you want to be able to give them information that they can easily access on their phone or their computer, where they're not going to be like getting their kid to do all that information for them. Like reduction of the clicks and the right placement of ads.
I think one thing you mentioned that's real key, and I just saw it lately, is where you just hit in your name and last four digits of your social security number, and they'll give a preliminary approval right off. That's all they need.
Okay.
Yeah. Any other thoughts on that?
I was thinking of something. Oh, it's... For me, I just really don't understand why they're just focused on refinancing. Like, there's a whole bunch of opportunity out there if they diversified their product offerings.
Yeah, we saw all those new
and they could pull through the demographic specific marketing and use their current customer base. They have kids, grandkids, whatever.
Mm-hmm. If they give the older folks the opportunity to give their children their generational access, because I know I go to a bank and it's my parents, and I'm going to probably stick with them if I can, because I know what I'm dealing with. So I don't know if Mr. Cooper can open something like that where they're like, okay, maybe we can give you an option or opportunity, or not a discount, but something along the lines of having family involved on top of your name so you can stay committed with a company like that. So.
Like some kind of reward, referrals, or something?
Well, I think you hit something really good there, Zane, because on the insurance side, veterans. What is it for veterans? Come on, I can't get the word out.
USAA?
USAA.
Yes.
Oh, multi-generational.
Right, where you could pass it down, and it's sort of like a privilege to be invited in because you get benefits. And if Mr. Cooper could, you know, reward those referrals, then it stays within the family. Mr. Cooper.
Well, thank you all so much for your time looking over these questions. You guys got a lot of great conversation and ideas out there about how we could go about this case study, and from there, I would like to move forward. Case study is to increase the customer adoption of self-service events and items that customers can utilize through Mr. Cooper. Now, that being said, the overall objective of our presentation today is to present a customer-centric strategy that focuses on seamless customer experiences, leading to cost reduction for Mr. Cooper. Now, to begin a case study, you usually find it very pertinent to look at your secondary and primary resources. And this is very important to do so that you can have a greater understanding of the industry in which a company operates within. In this case, that would be the mortgage industry. Now, for the sake of time, I would like to specifically focus on the strengths and the opportunities within the mortgage industry. Looking at the strengths first, you have three key strengths. First one, technology, standardization, and then specialization. Now, technology is simply becoming more and more integrated with the mortgage industry, and it's a force to be reckoned with. Standardization is a strength because after the subprime mortgage crisis of 2008, governmental controls were put into place to prevent bad mortgage loans from occurring, and this actually resulted in standardized processes for the mortgage loans. And the last item is specialization, because with very strict regulations. What comes from that is people that are specialized in actually going through the mortgage process and have a strong understanding of what it is. Now, the second area is opportunities. There are two key opportunities. The first one is mobile technologies and fintech. Does anybody here know what fintech is? Take a shot.
Is that like a click process program?
It's more simpler than that. It just means financial technology.
Oh.
And basically, it's the integration of technology into financial and loan services. And it's a huge industry that's starting to grow and become more and more prevalent, especially in interacting with the mortgage industry. The second item of opportunities is the mass exodus of larger bankers from the mortgage industry. And the reason that is because of stricter regulations that are harder to manage if you're a very large banker. Now, this has left a huge market gap for non-banking lenders such as Mr. Cooper to come in and take over that market.
Question.
Yes.
Are you going to go over the ONT more? The SWAT part?
The WNT?
WT, sorry. Yes.
For the purpose of time, I'm not going to cover those in detail today, but they are provided in the actual PowerPoint handout that I have for you guys. And if you have any questions more to go about that, you can certainly ask me at the end. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, to illustrate the importance of technology and its role in everyday life in the United States, the Pew Research Center measured smartphone usage among different age groups. Now, if you look closely, lo and behold, Mr. Cooper's largest age group of main customers from age 50 to 55 have an average smartphone usage rate of 74%. Now, this is significant in supporting the prevalence of technology in everyday use, and it also signifies the opportunity for Mr. Cooper to reach this age group, which just happens to be the main customer age group, through digital technology platforms.
Small question.
Yes.
Is this only for the U.S.?
Yes, this is specifically for the U.S. because Mr. Cooper doesn't operate outside of the U.S.
Okay.
I'm just thinking a little bit about 50 to 64, and I guess I fit in that range, but...
it turns on.
Yeah, we all have cell phones, smart. I mean,
self-recording.
The younger you are, the more technology savvy you are versus the older you are, depending on where you came from, is depending on your use of the technology.
Yes.
Even though you may have a smartphone, how much of the functionality of it that you use beyond just voicemail and making calls?
That's a really good point. And I don't have specific information on how they use their smartphone, but I can look that up and get that information to you.
Well, baby boomers are technology users, so that's good news.
Yes.
So I recall on the case study question there, or information, most of these people make calls. Do you think that's a personability thing? When you get an older range, they just want to be able to talk to someone and feel like their information is not being stolen off the internet, or what? How is Mr. Cooper handling? Are they trying to reduce calls and push it all on the computer screen?
With the problem intact at hand, that is your overall goal.
Okay.
But the one thing to keep in mind is, even though that is the task that has been given to us, that is merely a symptom level of a deeper rooted problem, mm-hmm. which is the lack of customer centricity in our own operations. And so actually, we looked more into that in our primary research, which I'd like to cover next.
Cool. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Now, for primary research, we conducted an online survey of approximately 30 individuals of varying age groups, and also personal one-on-one interviews. And what we found was there was actually a strong preference for digital interface usage when going through the mortgage process, which kind of touches on your question, Jane. And this comfort level with using this type of technology in the mortgage process is only growing. So what this further supports is an opportunity for Mr. Cooper to develop a customer-centric operation so that customers are able to self-service and use automation capabilities on their cell phones and as well as online. So I know I just covered a lot of information, but taking this information into account, as well as the case study questions that I presented to you, there are two complementary strategies that I would like to present for Mr. Cooper. And the first strategy is incentivizing mobile and web usage. And the second is individualized quality through a CRM system. Now, this will lead to
You guys know what a CRM is?
I'm sorry?
Can you explain the CRM?
Yes, CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management System. And I'll be using the term CRM to go through this presentation. And I'll touch a little bit more once I'm talking about the second strategy key about what a CRM actually entails.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. No problem. So the first strategy being proposed is incentivizing mobile and web usage. And what this means is promoting desirable customer behavior, which in this case is self-servicing and automation on the customer's end. This will actually be achieved through a reward program for Mr. Cooper called Cooper Rewards. Now you might be wondering why a reward program? There's so many of them. Goodness gracious. The answer is because they work. Reward programs are often also known as loyalty programs. And the reason is because the purpose of a reward program is to incentivize customers for performing a desired action by the company. And doing this repeatedly, a customer is rewarded and loyalty begins to develop to a brand. So in the case of Mr. Cooper, the purpose of Cooper Rewards is to add customer value to digital platforms available from Mr. Cooper, thus enticing customers to use these platforms. And that's how we get Cooper Rewards. Now, how will Cooper Rewards work? It'll be a point-based system in which customers that self-service themselves, like making payments, requesting assistance online, and other behaviors will be rewarded a certain number of points. Mr. Cooper will be responsible for forming partnerships with companies to provide beneficial discounts and other services to those customers that they can redeem for a certain number of Mr. Cooper points. But it's also important to know that how do they get this out here? And this ties back to marketing, as Mike said, and also, yeah, it was you, Mike, that you said marketing, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Marketing. That's a three-stage process in which the approach is focused on education, integration, and direction. And it's a three-way approach in which you are hitting the customer from all sides to adopt the digital self-service journey. As I just said, you're stimulating them from all sides.
Sarah, could you give me an example of how, one particular example of how that would work? Like,
mm-hmm.
obviously if I commit to automatic drafting of the payment,
yeah.
would that be a case where I win, we'll call it mileage?
In a sense it is similar to mileage points. In the case of automatic drafting, each time you probably get a set number of points when you start it and set it up. And then each time it occurs, you'll get a certain number of points rewarded to your Cooper Rewards, and it'll just continue to build up. And you can redeem it for any of the partnered discounts or beneficial deals that Mr. Cooper has set up through Cooper Rewards program.
But how does this play back to the real problem of, we'll call it post-sale support, mm-hmm. where you get these a million calls a month at $6 a whack, and basically $3.5 to $4 million a month of that is just supporting existing clients. How do you see the reward system working there?
So just to make sure I understand, how is the Cooper Reward Program actually targeting the root problem?
Yeah.
Okay. So Cooper Rewards will actually help to assist targeting the root problem of customer centricity by redirecting people from the call center to the digital platforms that Mr. Cooper has available to their customers. And through that, as it's incentivized, to use those platforms by the customer, they'll start to develop those habits and redirect their attention away from call centers.
So an example would be, I could call in and there would be an automated system that says, did you know you could earn 100 American Airline miles from going by using your phone or going online and doing these things?
Yeah.
If you'd like to do that, hang up and do that. If not, wait and whatever.
Yeah, I understand. That could be one of the forms of marketing.
Thank you.
Any other questions on this? Okay. Now for the second strategy, it is a customer relationship management system. And what this is, in the context of Mr. Cooper, the CRM would serve the goal of customer centricity by individualizing quality service and would act as an omni-channel system that would be used to monitor customer preferences, manage the Cooper reward system, and also facilitate marketing integration and monitor customer preferences. Now what that means is that, let's say for example, Key, you like to be texted about deals or things going on, versus Zane, you like to be emailed. And Hannah, you like to get a notification through an app. What a CRM does is it acts as a hub for storing customer information. And let's say Mr. Cooper would ask you, what is your preferred mode of contact? Once it has that information, it will continue to use that information and that form of contact to specifically market to an effective location, such as texting, email, app, to reach that customer. So, as a quick overview, here are the financial implications for Mr. Cooper. With the two complementary strategies that have been proposed, this will address the original problem at hand, a high level of misallocation of resources towards the call center by Mr. Cooper. The result will be an estimated 2-5% drop over the next year of incoming calls to the call centers. And this will actually result in approximately $1.5 to $4 million in cost savings per year, which is quite significant when you take into account that they're giving nearly 1 million calls per month.
Small question.
Yes.
About the calls.
Yeah.
So I know we have the loyalty program where you give them the opportunity to gain points or rewards.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they cut down the cost. Are they going to reduce the cost or keep it the same and make more money on top of the reduction? So how would they treat your clientele? So I know that you want to increase the profit, but how would you keep a balance in there?
Well, instead of focusing on increasing the profit, the goal would actually be to reduce the cost. And once you reduce the cost that are going out, you're able to redirect the cost savings back toward that digital self-service journey that the customer is undertaking and continue to invest in that so that it continues to improve throughout the time. Any other questions on that? That's a good question. Now, I know I provided you all with a lot of information in a very short time, and I really do appreciate you guys sticking around to hear it all, but I want to make sure that you guys walk away from this presentation with a clear understanding of the basic implications of today's presentation, and that is by concluding that there are clear strategic gaps between the technology-driven, individualized environment of the mortgage industry and Mr. Cooper's operations. So, with that, the twofold strategies that I present, which are incentivizing mobile and technology usage, and also individualized self-service through CRM quality, there are three key implications. We're going to create a very strong customer-centric focus, incentivize and promote the adoption of digital platforms by Mr. Cooper's customers, and last but not least, create an omni-channel experience in which the customers are going to reap significant benefits because they're going to be getting that consistent quality customer service throughout their entire experience with Mr. Cooper. Now, thank you so much for all of you coming here today. I really do appreciate your time and consideration of the strategic proposals that I've presented today. If you have any questions at this time or comments that you'd like to ask, feel free to do it right now.
Is the application free?
I'm sorry?
The phone application free?
Yes, it is.
The mobile one?
Mm-hmm. But the downside is you actually already have to be a customer to really even be able to log into it.
You can't even like try to set up mm-hmm. an account through that?
Okay. You have to have an account already.
That's a big barrier, right?
Yes.
Yeah, it sounds like you'd want to give away accounts, then sell mortgages.
Any other questions or comments that you guys have? No? Well, thank you all so much again, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.